Tiger Woods' ex-wife, Elin, has just purchased a $12 million mansion in North Palm Beach, Florida. However, she has also decided that she is going to bulldoze the entire thing and build a new house.
Oh, okay, so now there's some discussion as to whether she's so bitter at Tiger Woods that she's just basically taking a dump with his money. Okay, I don't know about that, because my sense is that rich people are so rich that they have forgotten like all context. Like, that looks like a gorgeous house to me, right? But a rich person sees that and goes, oh, please, it is not designed at all properly. I would do it totally different. You have to understand that probably the great amount of the money that they're paying is not for the house itself, but for the land. So they, let's just make some assumptions here and say the land is worth $10 million, the house that's constructed on top of it is worth $2 million. For a rich person, they're like, oh, please, it's a teardown. Take down a $2 million house, build another $2 million house on top of it, you retain most of the value, and you get to do it your way.
That's a possibility, definitely. I'm still leaning in the direction of her trying to show Tiger Woods, hey, this is what I'm doing with the $100 million settlement I won after you slept with 50 million women. But at the same time, I see your argument as well, because here, I'll give you an example. There's a show called The Real Housewives of Atlanta, right? And I don't know what these women do for their money. I know that they get paid about $79,000 a year for their participation in this reality show. Mm-hmm. But they're so bougie. Like, it's unbelievable to me, because they will not settle for a mega mansion. They have to live in a house that has never been lived in before, because they're disgusted by living in a house that used to have prior occupants. I mean, I don't know what the, I don't know where they get it from. And these women are just, I don't know.
That, look, that's the point of the show, to find obnoxious rich people and to put them on display. And then we develop a love-hate relationship with them. I don't know who loves them. I don't watch the show, but based on the descriptions, I do nothing but hate them. But because it's not a problem to have money. It's a problem to be an ass with your money, right? So, look, you want to bulldoze a perfectly great mansion, either out of spite for your ex-husband or because you have so much money you don't mind flushing down a couple of $1 million down the toilet? All right, great, no problem. Here's what I have, three words for you. Tax the rich.